Today's demonstration concerns a couple of AI features in App Connect Enterprise certified containers. That's part of the Cloud Pak for integration. You can see here that we're beginning by importing an OpenAPI document, and this describes a predefined interface that we're going to exploit when generating some integration logic. So this predefined OpenAPI defines how to retrieve a contact using its ID. You can see that it has a path parameter that carries the contact ID that's going to be used within a WHERE clause when we invoke a backend Salesforce system in order to give us a reply back again. And later in the demonstrations, we're going to invoke this example using the built-in testing tool that App Connect Enterprise has, and we're going to do that by passing in a contact ID. And switching my browser window to the Salesforce system, you can see there's a contact of Ben Thompson, who's a professionally grumpy IBMer. Any cheap joke to get some attention. And the purpose of this contact is that it's carried with the ID that I highlighted in the URL taskbar there. So by placing that ID into the tool, we're then going to be able to invoke Ben Thompson's information later on. The next stage of development is to select from Salesforce the object and the action that we want to execute. I've already filled in some credentials before today's demo, enabling this connection to happen even quicker. And as part of the steps that we're asked to perform once we've connected to Salesforce, we're going to define how many records we want to retrieve. In this case, we're just going to retrieve a single contact. And to define which contacts we want to retrieve, we'll be using the WHERE clause construct that we can see here, and we'll be passing in the contact ID from the inbound data that was passed as a path parameter into the message flow. So having saved that query, what we're next going to do within the flow is define a second action. So once we've retrieved the contact from Salesforce, we're going to summarize some information about that contact and place it into a Slack message. Again, we have predefined credentials that have already been dealt with, and in the dropdowns here, we're selecting to send a message to a public channel, and then the name of that channel is going to be My Channel. In the text box at the base of the screen, we're now going to insert a human readable message that will then be sent to Slack. And in this particular case, we're defining the fact that a contact has been successfully retrieved. And then dynamically added into that message, we're then going to select a couple of fields that have been returned to us by the preceding Salesforce node. So we have the first name of the contact, and we'll follow that up with the last name of the contact, the surname. And then we'll also include the contact description as well. And having provided these details, we have finished a very simple example of doing a mapping. But the other thing that we're going to do today is to demonstrate an AI feature that enables this mapping process to be completed even quicker and even easier. So the AI automated mapping capability that we'll be looking at next requires us to use a pre-trained algorithm that the product already provides. So if we navigate into the now renamed demo flow and we highlight the last node in the flow, we're going to be using these AI algorithms in order to more quickly create the response message, which is going to be sent back to the user. We've chosen the button there to look at some suggestions from that model. And you can see that in most cases, it's been quite successful in identifying suggested fields that should be mapped across. In fact, all suggestions that have a confidence score of 80% or greater are included within that auto map suggestion. There's also some lower level fields that the model might not be quite so sure about. You can see the percentage confidence that's provided using the little blue boxes on the right hand side of each of the field options. In these cases, we're taking the field name, the display name, its description, maybe the data type, and we're using these different aspects to give us a confidence around the semantic meaning of the field. The last thing we're going to do here is also demonstrate another feature called Data Assist. And Data Assist is slightly different. Here we're going to provide some sample data from an input and an output of the particular field that we're dealing with, and we're going to use this data to describe to our AI model a pattern of behavior. You can see that each of the example input phone numbers are each starting with an international dialing code, +44 for the UK in this example, and the output data has a leading zero. So we're going to exploit the model here to spot the pattern between these five examples and automatically generate for us a data transformation. And in this place, the JSON ARTA expression that's been generated notices that we have to strip off the +44 three characters at the beginning and substitute them with a zero. So having applied that logic, it saved us some time in doing that transformation or coming up with that code ourselves. What we can finally do is actually try out the flow. Using the built-in test utility, we can send in the contact ID that we saw earlier, and we can note the test results here have successfully shown that Ben Thompson is in fact a professionally grumpy IBMer, and the data has come also into our Slack console here as well. So we can see that the final output message has been written to Slack too. And that concludes the demo today of some brilliant AI features in App Connect Enterprise for certified containers.